Welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make bread bonda into the air fryer. Bread bonda is basically stuffed bread. Now, stuffing could be your preference. You can use your favorite stuffing, but I'm going to show you how quick and easily you can make potato peas stuffing for this recipe into the pressure cooker.
Chop onion very fine.
All right, onion is done.
Scrub potato skin, or you can just simply peel, but I like the taste of potato skin.
Wash scrubbed potato. Cut potato into slices.
Dice potato. As you can see, you can get very uniform diced potato.
Alright, so here I have potato diced nicely. Aloo. If you cut them in a big chunks, you can mash them later once the mixture is cooked. Here I have diced onion, yes, matar, green peas, ginger, garlic, green chili paste, adrak, lahsun, hari mirch. Here mere paas hai soaked poha. Soak poha for about 20 to 30 minutes only, and you can use in recipe or else you can just leave it out. And of course, I'll be using some spices from my spice box. On a medium to high heat, take oil into the pressure cooker pot. When the oil is hot enough, add cumin seeds, jeera, haldi, turmeric powder, dhania jeera powder, coriander cumin powder, lal mirch, red chili powder. Pehle dalenge onion, pyaz, salt, namak as per your taste, ginger, garlic, green chili paste, adrak, lahsun, hari mirch. Cook all these ingredients for a little bit. When onion is almost done, add garam masala, amchur powder, dry mango powder, or use lemon or lime juice. Matar, green peas. Smells amazing already. Next, potato, aloo. Mix really well. Alright, as you can see, I haven't added any water yet. Just sprinkle a little bit of water and that's about it. I'm going to cover the pressure cooker and hear only one whistle. Alright, so one whistle and turn off the stove. And look at it. Few more ingredients to add. Here I have poha soaked already, and as I said, it's optional to add poha, but it is kind of my favorite thing to do.
Chop coriander leaves really fine.
Aur bari kata hua dhania, coriander leaves. Mix it really well and let the mixture cool. As mixture cools down, you won't see any water even. Right now even there's no water, but once it cools down, you will have a nice pliable mixture to stuff. Alright, so you saw how quick and easy it is to prepare stuffing into the pressure cooker. Now this stuffing you can use in your samosas or any other kind of recipes that you can think of which you would like to stuff. And so here is the stuffing ready. If desired, you can also add some cheese. Kids really love the recipes that has cheese in it, so just jazz it up however you like. And now let's prepare the bread bonda, or vada also known as. Now make the balls when it has cooled down completely, about little smaller than lime, like so. And I actually decided to add some cheese in it. So here I have the white cheddar cheese. You can add as much or as little as you want. Just mix it lightly and start making the balls again. So here I have all the balls ready. Next, here I have some bread slices and I'm using whole wheat variety, but you can use your favorite kind of bread. If desired, remove the brown borders. So I'm going to finish with all the breads. Since I'm short of a whole wheat bread, I'm also using some jeera bread. Here I have a caraway seeds bread. The next step is to take milk or water. Take one bread slice at a time. Just slightly dip into the water or milk. Basically, just make it damp so that it gets easier to shape into balls. Squeeze out as much as you can. Place one ball in the middle and now shape it into the ball by pressing with both of your hands like this, as if you are making some laddus, like so. And I'm going to finish rest of the balls. All right, so here I have the balls ready. Preheat the air fryer at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 3 minutes. If desired, brush the balls with oil. Open the tray from the air fryer and arrange the balls inside the tray, like so. Going to put one more as it can fit in, and pop the tray inside the air fryer. And this time I'm going to set at 350 again for 6 minutes. And I'm going to check in between just to make sure that they are doing good and start. All right, so the 6 minutes has ended, so let's check. Look at them. They're almost done. I want a little bit more brown, so I'm going to pop back into it. This time just for another 3 minutes. All right, so the bread bondas are done. Look at them. I can hear the crispness. Serve with tomato ketchup. And my favorite way to serve these vadas are lightly apply the tomato ketchup and then dip into the sieve. And look at this, yum. So here I have the bread bondas or vadas ready. You can serve this bread bondas now with tomato ketchup, or you can have some with chutneys, dhania pudina chutney, which is coriander mint chutney basically, or you can use also date tamarind, kajur imli. And not only with chutneys or ketchup, you can serve this vada during tea time, tea or coffee, whatever you like. I love with masala chai. I am so ready to dig into this. Crispy outside and the stuffing inside with cheese, of course. Yummy. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please do like and comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for new recipe videos every week. And also please do visit my website bhavnaskitchen.com for new recipe tips, tricks and ideas in the kitchen. And do not forget to turn your notification bell on to receive new recipe videos every week. Thank you for watching and see you soon.